We've got a bunch of notes dispersed in our Obsidian. There is kind of a structure, especially if you're using Zettelkasten, but what if temporarily you want to organize your notes in a certain way? Just temporarily, you want to see a list, you want to see a table, you want to see your tasks. What do? Well, that's where the plugin Dataview comes in. Let me show you three use cases today. The three use cases I want to share with you today are one, keeping you on track with tasks in Dataview. So this is how you can find all the to-dos you've left for yourself in dispersed notes and collect them into one place. Two, it's about seeing the bigger picture. Of course, we have Graph View in Obsidian, which helps you see where the clusters of your dispersed notes are. But sometimes we just want to see a good old list, right, of all the titles of the notes. So Dataview is able to help you do that very quickly and very efficiently. Then number three is doing quick summaries of the lists that you've seen. Try to pick out the key information from each note so you don't have to click into every single one of them to see what is important. So let's get into exactly what they mean and how you can do these three things. First things first, how do you use Dataview? Let Obsidian know that you're using Dataview. First, you want to come to Community Plugins, browse for Dataview. And mine is already installed, but you can install it, you can update it, you can enable it. Then once you do that, you come back to any notes and you indicate that this is Dataview by typing in three backticks, Dataview in small caps, and three backticks again to close, to signal that this is the end. In between the backticks, this is where the magic happens, is where you can put queries or basically control find functions into Dataview. And there are four types. It's task, list, table. I've made sure they mapped to the use cases. And there's also calendar. I don't cover calendar in this video. I personally don't use it very much. I think it takes a lot of time for you to set up the calendar in your Obsidian, and then you have to learn how to query it. So it's way too complicated for most use cases, so I'm not covering it. If you're interested, let me know in the comments below and we can do another video on this. Okay, so that is the basics of Dataview. First, tasks, right? Basically, these are going to help you find all the checklists in your vault, and you can get them by pressing Control or Command L. This changed, it used to be Control Command Enter, but with a new update to Obsidian, they changed the hotkey. Now, how do you do this? Well, we talked about, we do three backticks, Dataview, and all we need to write is task space. Now, let's see what happens. Now, this probably looks very overwhelming and not very helpful. So what we want to do is filter the task, right? Instead of getting all the tasks in our vault, we probably want to see specific tasks. And for me, one that I check a lot is task from the hashtag newsletter. And literally it says task from newsletter. And when you click out, I have all the tasks from my newsletters. Now, what happens is the flow of how I do my input to output is I have notes that I find interesting and I decide I want to use them for newsletters, so I hashtag them newsletter. Then within that, because I find myself procrastinating a lot with these notes, what I do is for my future self, I leave a checklist of things I need to do. So when I find this note again, I can immediately get to work. And these are what the checklists are, and they will help me move closer towards from all this input to some sort of output. So for task is really great. It just to use task and then use from in order to search for your tags or from a folder. Again, I will leave all of these for you to copy and paste. You just have to put in the right tag or the right folder for your vault. Okay, let's move on to use case number two, which are lists. Lists are probably one of the most used Dataview queries for me. And basically, it's helping you search and list out all of the notes that are related to that search. And there are three main ways you might search, which are tags, folders, and text in title. So again, very similar to tasks, what we can do is a Dataview list. So this time we do list from the tag, let's say newsletter again. Now if we click out, it will give me all of the notes that I want to use for newsletter, right? And you can also use and. So let's say it's list for from newsletter and the hashtag build. This time I will get a shorter list that indicates that these nodes have both the tags list, newsletter, and build. Also, you can do or. So I can do newsletter or Twitter. Now here it will give me again a longer list of things that are either with the tag newsletter or Twitter. In this other video, I talk about it in depth of how I actually incorporate into my flow, so you can check that out for more details as well. Then let's look at folders, right? Very similar logic. You can also search instead of tags for folders. I know some of you also like to use folders, so same thing, three backticks, data view. Then we want list from and indicate folders with a quotation mark. So for example, let me get a list of books that transferred over from Readwise. So Readwise books, I think this is it. So I have these five books that came over from Readwise. So all you have to do is list from, then put quotation mark and the folder. If you have subfolders, you can use slash and then give the subfolder name. And if you also, you know, leave hints for yourself in the text of a title, same thing, backtick, data view, then we want a list. Now instead of from, which searches within a folder or searches within a tag, now we want to give it a condition, right, where the text, a specific text is in the title. So what we do is where contains, right? File name has dash book, right? So list where it contains dash book in the file name. Again, I will leave all of this for you to copy and paste in the description, so you don't worry about if you can't remember the syntax. But now it gives me all of the books that I have the dash book to indicate that this is also a book I've read, and this note is about a book. So in this way, you can, again, power up your search, not just with tags, not just with folders, but also with text in title. Now, once you have a bunch of lists of all the notes that are relevant to you, you want to know what's in the note itself, right? In order to get a quick overview of what did you write for these things. So that's where we move on to table. As you can imagine, table is a very structured way to look at information. So I actually don't use table very much for my idea generation and turning input into output. Rather, I like to use it for my books again. So same thing, three backticks, data view. Then we want table. And after table, you want to put the, other than seeing a list of the titles of the note, what other information do you want to see in the table? So let's say author and see what that does. Basically, it will show you a list of all the notes in your vault and the author information if the note has it. So for example, these ones don't, but some of them do. So this by itself is not very helpful. Again, so we want to filter our table with where are we getting the notes from. Right, so again, we say from, let's say the Readwise folder. Now, yeah, we have five notes in there. So now we can see it's all of these books, right, and the authors. So how does Dataview know what information to pick up for author? Well, let me show you in the actual note itself. You'll see here that there are two colons, and this is how we indicate to Dataview that this is information I want you to keep track of. Also, we've got title and we've got highlights. So let me show you how it looks in a table. Let's say we want to see author and highlights. So we just put a comma there, putting highlights, and now we have a table of the book name, the author, and the highlights. So first, how do you see we don't have anything in highlights for this note here? What happens is we didn't put anything there, so let's try now. Highlights. Okay, so now we come back to Dataview and it's automatically updated the highlights for us. All right, now for some minor formats, even though they don't matter, I know it can be annoying. So for example, I want to capitalize A, and maybe instead of writing highlights, I want to say insights or something, instead of going back into every single note and swapping out highlights for insights, what you can do is use the word as. So I want to show author as author with a capital A. And I want to show highlights as, let's say, insights. Right. So now author is capitalized, we've swapped out highlights for insights, and a table in this sense is a very powerful way to organize information you already have. But the thing is, you need to know in advance which information you actually want a data view to pick up. Since we don't want to annotate notes manually again and again, make sure to combine data view with templates, which I talk about here, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!